It's the second game of Group B for both Syria and Australia today at the Jassim bin Hamad Stadium. And both teams come in having got off the mark in Game 1. Syria recorded a goalless draw in their opener against Uzbekistan, but coach Hector Cooper suggested that his team were not looking to sit back and play for another point this time, despite the quality of today's opposition. Abdul Rahman Oais was arguably the star man last time out, as the team failed to register a shot on target, and they'll certainly be looking to improve on that one here today. Australia are the early pace setters in Group B after their 2-0 win over India a couple of days ago. Second half goals from Jackson Irvine and Jordan Boss got Graham Arnold's side off to the ideal start, and if they can back that up today, they'll be sitting pretty at the top of the table. Syria get the ball forward into the box for Ibrahim Bessai. He controls that well. He's got Pablo Sabag in support. Sabag takes the shot off the post and away with Matt Ryan beaten. So nearly a first competitive goal for Syria for Sabag. Nice move and not far from the opening goal after 5 minutes. He took the shot well. It'll be Connor Metcalf to deliver this free kick for Australia. Irvine's there, free at the back post, couldn't quite steer it on target. Australia really do possess that aerial threat, and they so nearly used it to their advantage. Ball's corner now for Australia. What can he do with this delivery? Jones at the front post, Irvine at the back post. He just couldn't quite get the crucial touch to turn it in for Australia. That was so close. And they've been turning up that pressure, but the best moments have come from set pieces. Syria on the attack now. It's an awkward clearance by Jones. Amar Ramadan is there, side netting only. Ramadan, who plays his club football in Slovakia, took rather a heavy first touch. He was always scrambling to get the shot away. Syria play it forward down the right. Hessar's dummied that, and the defensive pass gifts the ball to Sabag. What options does Sabag have? Goes for the shot himself. Ultimately, it's over and it's off target. Credit to Syria, though. They are finishing the half really well now. Just nothing on target. Goalless, we go in at the interval, but after resisting Australia's pressure, Syria grew into the contest later on. Boyle on the ball, darting inside from the touchline. Into the area he goes. Lucky bounce for Australia, and Irvine turns, and he prods the ball past the keeper. Australia have the lead just before the hour mark. Nothing that Ahmad Madania could do. It was all about the run from Boyle, but Irvine finished it off well. A poacher's finish, and that could be the step towards qualification that Australia were looking for. It's cleared out of the area there, only as far as Moayad Ayan. Oh, Ryan spills it! Has to get back and clear it. Scrambles it to safety eventually. Panic stations there for a split second, with the shot dipping just before the keeper. First shot on target for Syria at least, and a response to falling behind. Syria still looking for their chance to level this game. They take the free kick directly into the area. It falls for Omar Khribin. Turned well, but struck it over the top as he turned. Linesman's flag would have gone up anyway, but Syria are still struggling to get these efforts on target. Australia knocking the ball around comfortably now, deep into stoppage time with Syria leaving men forward. Silvera has a look at goal in stoppage time. No second goal just yet, but that should be that. And that will indeed do it for Australia. It wasn't a classic performance, but the solitary goal from Jackson Irvine is enough for 3 more points. And the Socceroos are through to the knockout stages after 2 wins from 2. Syria's spirited effort was not quite enough. They're still in with a chance before the last game.